Speaking of being safe and sound, a lot of parents are wondering if COVID shots for kids are safe. What are some of those risks?
Yeah, so we go to the very, very best. The number one doc, Dr. Marc Gillinov from the Cleveland Clinic, is here with more on what parents should know about these vaccines with their kiddos, whether or not they're safe, especially when it comes to concerns about the myocarditis that we've been seeing in the headlines a little bit. First of all, Doctor, great to see you.
Likewise. Good
Welcome.
To be here in person.
All right, so we're hearing this more and more. I know, it is great to have you here in studio, but let's talk about some of these risks and the risks and outweighing with benefits. Let's start with the myocarditis and what they're seeing. About 1,000 cases or so I've seen that we're seeing in mostly young adults or teenagers, mostly boys, men, young men.
Yeah. Well, if you'd step back and say any medical therapy, there are two things you want to know. What's the benefit? What's the risk?
Right.
Because there's no medical therapy that is risk-free. Even in the news recently, an aspirin has some risk. Mm-hmm. So what's the risk? What's the benefit? When it comes to the vaccines, and if you now just say, let's talk about kids, 5 to 11 years old, because that is the group that was recently approved for the Pfizer vaccine, the benefit, very, very high. More than 90% effective at preventing symptomatic disease. And that is the main thing that protects the child, because there have been deaths in kids from COVID.
Yeah.
It protects the child, it protects the family, it protects the extended family. What's the risk, what you were getting at? In the studies thus far of 5 to 11-year-olds, there have been no cases of myocarditis, no clinically recognized cases. I say clinically recognized because some of the data that you're talking about relates to, we get MRIs on people, and MRIs can show you clinically unimportant and irrelevant findings. Myocarditis just means some inflammation of the heart.
Okay.
But is that bad? Is it hurting people? In these kids, none of it was seen, so no myocarditis. In fact, flipping that around, you are more likely to get myocarditis, an inflammation of the heart, from COVID.
From a virus.
Than from the vaccine.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Interesting.
So it's, again, always the risk benefit, and you can choose to focus on risk or choose to focus on benefit, or you can do what the FDA and CDC did and say, all right, let's weigh these risk benefit, and where is the heavier weight? Which one wins? And in the case of the vaccine, the benefit far outweighs the risk.
And that was the advisory committee who talked about the 12 to 19-year-olds. That was what they did the initial study on. And so we did see, you saw some cases in that age range. Mm-hmm. But what are people, what should people be looking for if, you know, is this something that you can detect? Is there a test if you want to get, I mean, how do you balance that in a family?
Well, first thing is it's super duper rare.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. If somebody does get myocarditis, they feel sick. They get shortness of breath. They can get swelling of the ankles. And you can just feel a loss of energy. Again, super rare, meaning if I'm just out there living in the free world, I'm not every day thinking, I wonder if I have myocarditis.
Right.
I'd be more likely to think, if I have a sore throat, I wonder if I have COVID.
Mm-hmm. Are there any children, any teens, adults who should not be getting this vaccine? Are you seeing that there are, in some cases, some parents and doctors that are not advising it for kids with maybe pre-existing conditions? That I understand some kids need this because they have the pre-existing conditions. But I'm just saying, could something like this kind of set things off for a child more? Are there some parents that need to stay away from this with their kids?
Probably not. At this point, there is no pre-existing condition that is what we call a contraindication.
Mm-hmm.
And it's actually more on the side of what you brought up. Kids who are vulnerable to health problems should, in almost all cases, get the vaccine. That said, it's a good discussion to have with the pediatrician. Mm-hmm. I personally would not go to the internet and say, all right, I'm going to figure this out.
Yeah.
I would go to a pediatrician, an infectious disease expert, a virologist. I wouldn't rely on just what did I get when I put this into Google.
Yeah, that's a slippery slope to go down.
Because you can
right?
find anything you want.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Dr. Marc, appreciate it, man. Thank you so much. Good information
on
myocarditis. And of course, if you want more information, fox8.com. You can always get a hold of Dr. Marc, and we can pose some questions to him. We love to ask him questions all the time when he comes onto the show. So, Dr. Marc, thank you. Appreciate it.
All right, welcome.
Good information.
Thank you.